Weather surveillance indicates turbulence out there. Try not to get knocked out of the sky.
Got it.
Where does she think she's going?
You want to head out with the boss?
That'll be the day.
I don't see a problem with it, so long as she's with you. She's a crack shot, damn fine scout. Well suited for a clandestine op. Which is more than I can say for the others.
There's nothing damn fine about this thing.
Here.
Hey.
Blades.
Wait a minute, that thing costs a lot of money.
See each individual blade and a depth perception.
One in.
This is ridiculous. She doesn't talk. How could you possibly stay in communication?
Right. I like working solo anyway.
Angola's Mfinda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area in crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. To the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated, abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cyphers. Keeping tabs on UNITA could tell us who's pulling its strings. hunt tracking down Skullface and Cypher with him. Good luck, boss. First, make your way to the oil facility. It's to the north, past Wala Yamasa. The village is currently occupied by UNITA, so stay sharp. The war industry we started has taken a pretty crooked course these past 9 years. With no other options, soldiers have become dogs of war, sent to conflict zones as private forces, or PFs. Guys we fought alongside are dying all around the globe for no reason. No banner. But it's how they survive. The demand for PFs here in Africa is especially high. Cold War standoffs, resource exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries has only brought conflict here. That mess you're standing in is just the latest example. It's digitalis. It's toxic, but it can also be used as medicine. You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA, meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands. Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Okay.
Extract him. Destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid.
Ik wil niet vechten.
Talk.
Ik ken geen Engels niet. Ik jammer.
The PF soldiers are speaking Afrikaans, an official language of the Republic of South Africa. Boss, we're gonna need someone with the Afrikaans interpreter skill to understand what they're saying. We'll look into it here, but for now, you'll just have to make do without one. There's the transfer pump control room. The emergency stop button is probably inside it.
Are you near there? Stand by.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. Destroy that separator tank. You'll need to use explosives. Got any C4? Alright, you planted the C4. Don't set it off until you're at a safe distance. Explosion. Get out of there ASAP. Facility all the while pretending they were the victims. One other thing. Sanger's Johannesburg head office is just a room in a multi-tenant building. Company's essentially non-existent. 3 years ago, that investment fund stepped in and started gutting it through a series of mergers and sell-offs, and get this, the fund itself no longer exists either. It's a shell corporation, meaning someone is just using Sanger's name from the shadows. But what about those strange corpses? Just what the hell were they doing over there?